What's happening everyone, my name is Alex and welcome back. In today's video we are checking out one of the latest phones from YumiDigi called the YumiDigi Bison. So this is basically an affordable rugged phone that gets decent specs. So inside this phone we have the MediaTek Helio P60 that's paired with 6GB of RAM and 128GB of internal storage. And that internal storage is actually more than you get with the base iPhone 12, just in case you're wondering. Alright, so with a setup like that, we get an AnTuTu score of about 130,000. And you already know that you're not looking at the fastest phone out there, but you're looking at a phone that will perform decent enough for most applications, so basically for most people. Alright, so starting with a super quick unboxing, the phone comes in a white looking box, nothing that special about the box, and inside the box you're obviously gonna find the phone itself. We have a little user manual, the power adapter, and the USB-C cable. So that's about it for the box. The phone itself doesn't look bad at all for a rugged phone. We usually get bigger and thicker phones when we get rugged phones, but not this one. This one looks actually pretty good and it fits in my pocket really well. Inside it, we have a 5000 mAh battery, so you can easily get between 8 and 10 hours of screen on time, depending how you use the phone. And the phone also supports fast charging, so charging this from 0 to 100 is done in about 2.5 hours. On the front, we have a 6.3 inch screen. This is an IPS panel that has a 1080p resolution. So pretty good looking screen, great viewing angles, and the screen does get bright enough so the phone can be used outdoors, and that's definitely important. Now, the phone is made out of a combination of plastic and metal. So we have some metal strips on the left and on the right hand sides. On the left hand side, we have the slot for the SIM card. This device can take two SIM cards or a SIM card and an SD card. And since we are talking about SIM cards, it also supports a lot of bands. So you're gonna be able to use this phone pretty much anywhere in the world, including the US. So very important for sure. Next to that SIM card slot, we have the fingerprint scanner, but the positioning of the fingerprint scanner is a bit strange. So when I pick up the phone with the right hand, I kind of have to touch the fingerprint scanner with this finger. So it is a bit awkward to do. If I pick it up with my left hand, then it's easier to unlock. But overall, the positioning of the fingerprint scanner is not great. However, when you pick the phone up in the right way, you can easily unlock it with your finger. So the fingerprint scanner does work good. And next to that fingerprint scanner, we have what they call a customizable button. But unfortunately, the one on the left-hand side of the phone is not really customizable. I couldn't find the settings for it anywhere. There is another one of these buttons on the other side of the phone. And for that one, yes, you can customize it, but not the one on the left. So many times when I pick up the phone, I actually press that button by mistake, and every time you press that button, an app called Zolo opens up, and that's an app that I will never use. So hopefully that gets addressed in a software update in the future. On the other side of the phone, we have the volume keys, we have the power button, and as I said, the other customizable button. You can actually customize it to whatever app or action you need. The phone has a 3.5mm audio jack at the top and the USB-C charging port at the bottom. And I'm very happy to see that we actually have that audio jack at the top there. On the back of the phone, we have the holes for the speaker. And unfortunately, this is the only speaker available on this phone. The speaker does get loud enough, but whenever you're holding the phone like this so you can actually watch a video, the sound kind of goes away from you. So I was really hoping we would have dual speakers, but that's not the case, unfortunately. We also have a bunch of cameras on the back there. We have an ultra wide lens, we have the main lens, we have a macro lens, but realistically the cameras aren't that great on this phone. So I don't think you're buying this phone for the cameras. I mean, I'm showing you some pictures that I took with it earlier today, and as you can probably see for yourself, nothing that special for any of those pictures. But this is kind of the norm when you get one of these affordable rugged phones. I mean, I haven't really tried any rugged phone that got great cameras. And I think that makes sense because they have to cut corners somewhere. The maximum recording resolution with this device is also 1080p, but the image stabilization doesn't seem to work that well or to be available for those recordings. So, as I said, you are definitely not buying this phone for its cameras. I was happy to see that it has an NFC chip inside, and that means that you can use this phone to make payments using Google Pay. We also have a really good GPS unit inside. It takes like less than half a second for the phone to find your location, so that means that any navigation application that you're gonna use like Google Maps or Waze will work great. And the phone also has a lot of sensors, more sensors than we usually see in affordable phones like this one. The phone runs Android 10 right out of the box, and I was also very happy to see that it doesn't come pre-installed a bunch of useless apps. With a lot of cheaper devices, you do see a lot of useless apps that are pre-installed, but not this one. This one only comes with some Google apps pre-installed. The UI is also very smooth, so moving in between screens, opening apps or closing apps is done really well, actually much better than I was expecting. And I've also tried a bunch of apps with it, like Facebook, and scrolling through your feed does work much better than I was expecting once again. The same goes for Chrome and basically all the other social media apps. I was also able to play some games on it, and I played Call of Duty because I feel that's a popular game. And once again, the phone does perform quite good for that game. Of course, I don't have the game set at the maximum graphics settings, but for a budget phone that's also a rugged phone, I feel that that game does really well. So overall, I am very happy with the performance that we get from that MediaTek Helio P60. So for the price, you can't really go wrong with a phone like this. I mean, it does perform much better than I was expecting. It does look pretty good, but the weakest thing about this phone are the cameras. So if you're looking for a phone that has great cameras, I feel that this is not gonna be the right phone for you. But if you're on the market for a rugged phone that feels pretty decent, it's not that heavy and it performs well, this is definitely one that you should consider. Alright guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.